We volunteer time, and even our kids end up coming too. They just love to come hand out the food. But now they need person to come and direct directions, probably because I'm the loudest one.
Macoletta, like other volunteers across the state, are helping the Utah Food Bank with the Feed Utah Food Drive to collect and distribute food to people impacted by the COVID-19 crisis.
We do have a little family-operated restaurant. During the pandemic, we were asked to close, and of course we did. And when it was opened up, it was not doing well. I just lost my husband. This is a big relief. This is very helpful.
Here at the Utah Food Bank, the need has increased dramatically.
Earlier this week, community and faith-based entities, including leaders from the Church of Jesus Christ of Latter-day Saints, joined forces with the local food bank to support the ever-increasing number of Utahns that face hunger.
COVID has changed many, many things in our lives. It's changed many things in the families' lives that we serve.
Over 500,000 people in Utah, and one in five children are at risk of missing a meal today. Now, what we're here to talk about is the thing that Utah does best. It's a thing we're recognized for around the world, and that is giving back.
Isn't that how we build our communities and strengthen them? By serving the way our Savior Jesus Christ would serve. And so it is to care for those in need.
Did you guys know that there are kids who are hungry?
Latter-day Saints of all ages and countless others across the state enlisted in the cause to extend a helping hand to their neighbors in need.
We are here today to drop off flyers on people's doors to invite them to donate food. We're going to address the issues of, kind of educate the kids about what is going on in the world before we go hand out the flyers so they know and have a greater sense of purpose of what they're doing today.
I hope to feed a lot of families who need help with that and are hungry.
I think this is important because Jesus helps a lot of people.
Nearly a week later, youth from the church's young women and young men organizations returned with a mission to pick up hundreds of bags filled with offerings from Utahns who emptied food from their home pantries to fill up the hearts and stomachs of their fellow neighbors in need.
There's times when you think, are there enough good people in the world? And I think it's more important now that we come together as a people and just support each other.
We're living in some very unprecedented times, and it calls for us as brothers and sisters in the brotherhood and sisterhood of humanity to come together and compile our efforts, whatever they may be.
I feel very grateful, and I'm also contributing myself to the food drive. Anytime you take something, you also have to give. It goes both ways. You give and you receive. That's how it works.